What does it mean to be the first female self-made billionaire in American history? If there was ever the original influencer, it's Martha.
The hardest thing is to retain cultural relevance as an older woman, and she's done it.
I was considered crazy, but it worked. She was preposterously perfect.
Perfect, perfect little pattern.
Ooh, perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect.
Things look fabulous, but are they?
Young women, listen to my advice. If you're married and your husband starts to cheat on you, he's a piece of shit. Get out of that marriage.
Didn't you have an affair early on?
Yeah, but I don't think Andy ever knew about that.
I'm strict and I'm demanding and I'm all those good things that make a successful person.
In the business world, that's a great trait for a man. But for a woman, you know, she was a bitch.
All of that did inspire me tremendously. I was on the top of the world.
And then the worst thing that could possibly happen happened.
Martha Stewart was indicted on criminal charges.
This is a targeted prosecution. It's what we're calling a bitch hunt.
I was a trophy for these idiots. I was dragged into solitary, no food or water. Those prosecutors should have been put in a Cuisinart and turned on high. I had to climb out of a hole.
I am free. No ankle bracelet.
You expected her to do something soft, but she went the other way.
Smoking on Kush in hot pot.
What is more important, a marriage or a career?
You tell me.
I don't know. The cookie cutter house and the cookie cutter life was not for me.
I like the way you're spinning that sugar around them balls, Martha. That's nice.
I have two mottos. Learn something new every day, and when you're through changing, you're through. I could have just been a miserable has-been housewife, but I didn't let that happen to myself. And I'm so happy I didn't.